You're watching Electrical Engineering Lectures channel. For more videos, please do like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for the latest notifications.
Welcome to another video. In the previous video, I've shown you how to read multiple analog signals. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to read temperature with PIC microcontroller using LM35 analog temperature sensor. So the whole video is basically comprised of three parts. First, I will give the brief overview of LM35 temperature sensor, followed by a C program to interface this sensor. And lastly, I will show you the simulation that how my program is working. So let us continue with the presentation. The temperature is the most widely sensed parameter of all physical parameters because of its significance on material and processes at the molecular level. Also, the temperature is a specific degree of hotness or coldness as reference to a specific scale. Our temperature sensors monitor the changes that take place in material or objects as their temperature changes. The temperature sensor can detect a change in physical quantity that corresponds to temperature change. The physical quantity can be anything, like resistance or voltage. So we have different types of temperature sensors. Mainly they are categorized into two types. First one is the contact base and the second one is non-contact base. In contact base temperature sensing, the sensor will be in physical contact with the object that is being sensed. In non-contact base temperature sensing, the sensor interrupts the radiant energy of the heat source. The radiant energy is the form of energy emitted in the infrared portion of electromagnetic spectrum. So I'll give the example of non-contact temperature sensor, such as IR temperature sensor, which measure the temperature through infrared. Similarly, we classify the contact temperature sensors into three different categories. First one is the thermocouple. So the basic principle of thermocouple is that when two conductors of dissimilar metals are joined at an end of a circuit, they form a thermocouple. They do not contain any sensing element like resistive temperature devices, so they are less limited in terms of material use. But they can handle much higher temperature than resistive temperature devices, ranging up to 1700 degrees Celsius. The next category is the resistance temperature detectors. They are quite similar to the thermistor, in which the electrical resistance is changes with the temperature. So the resistive temperature devices consist sensing elements, connecting wires, and measuring instruments. They are categorized further into two types. First one is the positive temperature coefficient, PTD, or the other one is the negative temperature coefficients. And the last category is the semiconductor based sensors, which include LM35, DS1820, DHT22. Most of them are analog, but recently the sensors are digital. So we will talk about analog sensor, which is LM35. LM35 is an integrated analog temperature sensor whose electrical output is proportional to degrees centigrade. The LM35 sensor does not require any external calibration or trimming to provide typical accuracies. The LM35's low output impedance, linear output, and precise inherent calibration make interfacing to read out or control circuitry especially easy. These are the features of LM35 sensors. The first is that it is almost linear with 10 millivolts per degree C scale factor and very accurate, ranging up to 0.5 degree C for full scale range. Also, it can measure from minus 55 degree C to 150 degree C, and it can operate at a voltage of 4 to 30 volts, and the non-linearity of this sensor is only 0.25 degree C for the full range. So this is the pinout of LM35. You can find the LM35 in TO92 package, in which there are three pins. The first is for the positive supply, the center or the second one is the output, and the last or third pin is the ground. So if you use in this configuration with a single supply, then it will give you a temperature measurement range of 2°C to 150°C, and if you apply or use dual supply, then you can use full range from -55 to 150°C. So let's get back to writing a program to interface LM35 for temperature measurement. This is our main interface of the PICC compiler. As I am using PICC compiler for the C programming of PIC microcontrollers, and if you missed the previous videos, I'll just give a flashback of these commands. The first command will always be to include a device header file. I am using 16F877A PIC microcontroller 40 pin device for this code. The next is hash device ADC equal to 10, which defines the number of bit for ADC. As this device has 8 channels of 10 bit ADC, therefore you have to define 10 here. The next command is to include a header file for math, and this is for handling the computation in the program, followed by hash fuses, which is XT. This is for using the crystal of frequency less than 4 MHz, and then no watch timer, and I don't want my code to be protected, therefore I have used no protect fuse. Then hash use delay clock equal to 4 MHz. This is command to use an external oscillator of frequency 4 MHz. If you are going to use another frequency like 8 or 10, you have to write in digit form here. Since I am displaying my results on the LCD, so I have to include LCD.c. This is a built-in LCD driver for the PICC compiler. So don't forget to include this C driver. Then comes LCD initialization, which is always be in the main loop. As I've previously told in my last video that we need to use 4 built-in commands of PICC compiler in order to read analog signals. The first one is the setup ADC ports. It will set up the number of pins to be used as analog. If you write all analog in the argument, all the available pins that can be used as analog will be now assigned as analog pins. The next is setup ADC, and in the argument of this command you can either use internal clock, or you can also use another command that will divide the oscillator frequency, but right now I am only using the internal clock. Then comes my infinite while loop, in which I have to write the first command, which is set ADC channel 0. This command will specify the channel to be used for the analog, to read the analog signal, and I am using channel A0 or A0 to read LM35 output. The next built-in function for PICC compiler is read ADC. It will read the input analog signal and will convert it into the digital value. The conversion is based on this formula. So the digital value will be equal to analog value multiplied by 2^ number of bits of ADC. In our case, this is 10. -1 divided by 5 volts. Since we are not using external voltage reference, so our voltage reference in case of this conversion will be over equal to the bias voltage, which is in our case is 5 volts. So this is delay microseconds 10. This is for the settling time of A to D converter. Whenever you want to measure multiple analog signal, you have to insert this delay in order to settle the A to D converter. Then in order to convert back into the analog value, you need to multiply the digital value by this factor, which is basically equal to 5 over 1023. I normally use a multiplication operator rather than a division operator, and this is a very good strategy in PICC compiler. Always go for multiplication factor. So The multiplication factor in this case is 0.00488. It will convert the digital value back into the analog value. The analog value read by the microcontroller is in volts. So first we have to convert this value into the millivolt. So I have to multiply it by 1000. So it will convert this volts into millivolt. Now, as I have told you, that LM35 output is 10 millivolts for 1 degree Celsius. So if I have to measure the temperature in degree Celsius, so I have to convert the output or the millivolts by 10. So if I have to measure the temperature, then I have to divide the output of the LM35 by a constant 10, so that it will automatically convert it into degree Celsius. So again, I am using a multiplying operator, which is 0.1. So when I multiply this by this variable, it will give me a temperature in degree Celsius, and then I will display this both the analog value, which is the output of LM35, and over actual temperature in degree C on the LCD. So now it's time to play the simulation and see whether our program works or not. First, let us build the program. So this is the main interface of Proteus 8.9. As I have already drawn the schematic, you can find the library of LM35 in Proteus. Just write LM35 in the component list and you can find it. Let me do it for you. Select P and then you can write LM35. Here you go, a precision centigrade temperature sensor, and you can also have the library of this temperature sensor for your PCB maker. Click OK. So I have connected pin 1 with VCC, pin 2 which is the output with my pin A0 of the microcontroller, and pin 3 is with the ground. So let's play the simulation, and you can see that when I set the temperature on LM35 equal to 28, the output of LM35 is 280 millivolts and my microcontroller is reading 28.3. Now if I increment this temperature by 0.1, you can see there is no change in the measured temperature. 0.2, still no change. 0.3, 0.4. Now you can see the difference, and the measured temperature is changed. Why is it so? It is because that our A to D converter is 10 bit, which means that the minimum resolution we can acquire is 4.88 millivolts, which in case of LM35 corresponds to 0.5 degree C temperature. So if you want to read with the resolution of 0.1 degree C, you can have two options. The first is you can amplify the input signal of LM35 to minimum of 5 times. Then you can easily read with 0.1 resolution. The another technique is that you can use external reference voltage. So I will explain the second method, which is to use the external voltage reference. So let's get back to the main program. Now I have to comment this section of the code. Toggle comment and uncomment this section. So after uncommenting the program, let's just go at the start of the program. Now I have to comment this command and uncomment this command. So what will this command do? Since I am going to use the external reference, so this command will ensure that you can use the external reference. Since most of the pins in the microcontroller are multi-purpose, that is, they can be used as analog, digital, or some specific function. Therefore, we have to refer to the device header file to see which pin can be used as V reference. So here you can see that A3, which is an analog pin, can be used as external V reference. To make a 3 external V reference, we have to use this constant, which is 3, in this command, so that A0, A1, A2 and A4 will be used as analog pins and A3 will use as the external reference voltage pin. So what I have done, I have written 03 in hex form in the argument of setup ADC ports. So this will set up the analog pin as VREF to be used for the external voltage reference. By doing this, this is all set. Now we need to change the factor, so to convert the digital value back into the analog value. Now since we are using 1 volt in my program as the V reference, so the constant will now be equal to 0.0009775, which is equal to 1/1023 instead of 5/1023, as 1 is my external V reference. Again, the same command will follow. That is, I will convert the analog value, which is in volts, into millivolts, and then I'll divide by 10 to get the temperature in degree C. And finally, I will display the output of LM35 and actual temperature in degree Celsius, but now with an external V reference of 1 volt. Now build this program. Now once again, play the simulation. Now you can see that 28 is set on the LM35 and this is displaying 281, which is the output of LM35 in millivolts, and temperature is 28.1. There can be a slight error because of quantization and also the resolution. Now I will increment the temperature by 0.1 and you can see that actual temperature is also changes by a factor of 0.1. This is how you can achieve high resolution of 0.1 degree C by using external voltage reference.
So this is all from this video. I have given a link in the description where you can download C source file, hex file and Proteus simulation file. Just go there and download all the files. If you have any difficulty, just write down in the comment box and I will try to answer them as soon as possible. So keep watching and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.